So this might be the clip where she actually talks about what happened to her when she was a child, when she was molested.
Oh, okay.
So. Good stuff for a comedy special.
Yeah, right. Really hilarious. Rape is really hilarious.
For a comedy special. Yeah. I'm going to tell a very serious, somber story, by the way, everybody.
Yeah.
Bad jokes at the moment. Our obsession with reputation. We're obsessed with it. We think reputation is more important than anything else, including humanity. And do you know who takes the mantle of this myopic adulation of reputation? Celebrities and comedians are not immune. They're all cut from the same cloth.
This is a weird
Donald
speech.
Donald Trump, Pablo Picasso.
Oh, Donald
Harvey
Trump.
Harvey Weinstein. Bill Cosby, Woody Allen, Roman Polanski. These men are not exceptions. They are the rule.
What about Bill Clinton? Why don't you start mentioning...
She didn't mention Bill Clinton.
Yeah. What about those types of people?
Yeah.
What about Joe Biden?
Right.
And they are not individuals. They are our stories. And the moral of our story is we don't give a shit. We don't give a fuck about women or children. We only care about a man's reputation. What about his humanity? These men control our stories.
I don't know about you, buddy, but I'm laughing my balls off over here.
Yeah,
on
right.
the inside.
Yeah, right. I'm sure Donald Trump is controlling the story of her life. I'm sure he gives a fuck.
Yeah.
Just like E. Jean Carroll.
Yeah.
Who thinks rape is hot.
Which, by the way, that was a total bullshit.
Yeah, no
fucking
shit.
Lawsuit.
Yeah, no shit.
She had a cat. Her name was Vagina.
Yeah. And she had a black boyfriend she called Ape.
Vagina. I died when he said that,
yeah,
by the way.
Yeah.
And yet they have a diminishing connection to their own humanity, and we don't seem to mind.
Imagine this. We live in a world now where, like, this is a comedy special, right?
Yeah.
And then you watch a presidential, like, debate, and
yeah,
that's far more hilarious.
Yeah, that's the comedy special.
Yeah. Ted Cruz, his dog's a wife, or his, his wife is a dog. I fucked that up. Oh, my God.
His wife is a dog.
What an idiot I am. Said that backwards.
Oh, that's hilarious.
So long as they get to hold on to their precious reputation. Fuck reputation. Hindsight is a gift. Stop wasting my time. If you...
Nobody cares about you, lady.
Look, I am angry.
This is cringe, by the way.
This is so cringe.
This is
so cringe.
This is a comedy special. I just want to point that out.
Yeah, right.
This is a comedy.
There was no comedy yet in here. Yeah. I think I'm just listening to a lecture from somebody.
Right.
At like some sort of feminist BLM
right,
rally.
An angry lesbian,
yeah,
yelling
right
at you.
Yeah.
Wait, there was a laugh. Hold on, there was a laugh.
Oh yeah,
I'm sorry. We were jabbering like a bunch of privileged men.
Yeah,
we're
a bunch of privileged men just mocking a dumb lesbian.
Yeah, so let's hear. I want to hear the laugh.
Look, I am angry. I apologize.
As the speaker is just projecting laughter.
Yeah. It's a big sign. This is laugh.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Or get shot.
And there's what do you call it?
Nazi Gestapo guards
with,
that will
yeah,
murder you
guns.
If you don't laugh.
Yeah.
I know there's a few people in the room are going, ah, look, I think she's lost control of the tension. That's correct. I did a bit there. Oh. So I'm not very experienced in you know, controlling anger. It's not my place to be angry on a comedy stage. I'm supposed to be doing self-deprecating.
Because men are supposed to be angry.
Okay, so this here, I remember this part. This is where she goes, this is supposed to be a comedy special, so I should be doing self-deprecating humor, but I'm not going to do that tonight because I have already been abused enough.
Oh,
and I'm
oh.
taking a stand. And then, like, the New York Times and all the major... Legacy media,
yeah, the legacy CIA media.
Praise this as like some amazing anti-comedy that was just brilliant. So,
oh my God.
Oh, this is so-
Whoever reads New York Times, all this stuff, you guys are mooring. It's Mockingbird Media coming out of the CIA to mind control you, you dumb retards.
This is, you're going to love this, dude, because this is cringe. So just hold
yeah.
tight, you white privileged man.
Yeah.
By
the way, I'm a black girl
I'm
with
sorry.
A huge
sorry.
Dick.
Sorry.
You're misgendering me.
I'm sorry.
You asshole.
I'm the white privileged man.
Yes, you are.
Safer when men do the angry comedy. They're the kings of the genre. When
that's
I
right,
do it,
that's
bitch.
Right, because we're good at it.
Yeah, we're good.
Dummy.
And you suck.
Women aren't that funny.
Yeah,
and we are.
And I would look
get
much,
used to it,
much better in your glasses and your clothes. And I don't have the dumb fupa you have. and all right. whatever dumb looking.
We're going off of two different rants here.
All
right.
I'm just insulting her ugly appearance. That's all.
How much better you would look in her clothes?
Yeah, right. Yeah. I look better in your panties. I look better in everything, in your bra.
I'm just a miserable lesbian ruining all the fun on the banter. When men do it, heroes of free speech.
Give us an example.
I love angry white man comedy.
I love it when a white person bitches about like white people.
Yeah, right.
As if, I'm sorry, are you not a white person?
Yeah, right. Uh-huh.
You could be more white. You're Australian.
Yeah.
You're not even like, there's no ethnicity to that. It's just.
Yeah, your lineage comes from prisoners that were sent from England.
So funny. It's hilarious. Oh, they're adorable. Why are they angry? What's up, little fella? What are they angry about? Gosh, can't work it out. They're like the canaries in the mine, aren't they? If they're having a tough time, the rest of us are goners.
I don't even get these jokes. I really don't.
She's just bitching about how men get to be the arbiters of comedy, and when a woman does it, they're
lesbian. Well, let's just face it, because men are 1,000 times better at comedy than any woman.
I hate to say this, but there is a biological reason why men are funnier than women.
Yeah.
There just is. Women don't have...
Because also, women bring all this emotional baggage into crap.
Women don't have a biological reason to be funny. Do you get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what are one of the reasons why women are attracted to us? Because we're funny.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you attracted to women because they're funny?
I don't think I've ever met a funny woman in my life.
That's what I'm saying.
Unless it was accidental, like they fell down the steps or something. You know?
Unless they injured themselves.
Yeah, that's when it's funny.
But they don't have... Like, women can't court us in that way. We're attracted to you for overlooks.
Yeah.
And you're attracted to us for intangibles.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
So, sorry, that's just how... So, men that happen to be funnier, right, are high up on the pyramid food... pyramid food chain.
Yeah.
As far as courting women. So.
Yeah. You know what? I've changed my mind.
Yeah?
I think she's very attractive.
And hilarious.
Yeah. Dude, this is the funniest comedian I've ever heard in my life.
Right.
Have you heard me just laughing my ass off for the last whatever?
I read a couple New York Times articles, and now I think she's hilarious.
I mean, the New York Times, it's just the best paper out there. Yeah. Like, I'd recommend anyone to read it. And the Wall Street Journal spent $5 a day on that magazine or that newspaper.
Salon Magazine told me this was brilliant.
Yeah, and so, I'm
I think
fully
it's funny
for
now.
It. Yeah. I'm actually a feminist too, by the way. I pose as the angry man, but secretly inside, I'm a feminist. And
we're imprisoned because of the patriarchy.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. We got to get rid of men. Right. I mean, women just need to control the earth, and that's just
It'd be a lot better off.
It'd be a lot better. Yep. You know, just all these mindless women who can't find their ass from a hole in the ground. You know, that's who we need to run the country.
Sorry, I told about that young man who almost beat me up. It was a very funny story. It was very funny. I made a lot of people laugh about his ignorance, and the reason I could do that is because I'm very good at this job. I actually am pretty good at controlling the tension, and I know how to balance that to get the laugh at the right place. But in order to balance
the tension... Wow, she is an egomaniac, too.
Yeah, right?
Like, oh, I'm so good at doing this, I'm so good at...
I'm so convinced, if we had to bet money, that she is a plant.
Oh, yeah.
Without a doubt,
she's a plant puppet.
Believe that she worked nightclubs, made all these drunks laugh enough, where she climbed the corporate ladder to Netflix, right?
Yeah.
To earn a special.
Yeah.
I've never seen this bitch on a show
this
of any
is
kind.
What a Davos World Economic Forum would be like, boom, she's perfect.
Yeah.
Elevator to the top, all these Netflix specials, especially when you're getting positive articles written in New York Times, clearly.
Right.
Clearly,
and you're getting positive articles.
You're part of the establishment.
In every legacy media, like I didn't see one piece of media that actually go. You know, I don't really think this is that funny. It's it's dull.
Dull.
It's just a woman complaining on stage.
No humor in it at all.
You know, which by the way, men in general are funnier, but that does not mean every comedy special I've ever seen, which are mostly by guys, is funny.
Yeah,
In fact, most of them are so unfunny.
Yeah, right. There's so many terrible men comedians. Honestly, the state of comedy in 2023 is pretty bad, honestly.
The fact that, like...
People are afraid to say stuff, it is ridiculous.
I would rather watch Dan Silly videos on YouTube...
That's hilarious.
...than any of the stand-up specials on Netflix.
Yeah, even a lot of the male comedians I used to respect are like, dude, you guys became pussies.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Any comedian that got through the Trump era and didn't turn into like some little baby.
The Trump or the COVID era and turned into some just like, a horrible baby. Exactly.
Yeah. So there's really not that many left.
No, honestly. No, not really.
No.
Story. I couldn't tell that story as it actually happened. Because I couldn't tell the part of the story where that man realized his mistake. And he came back. And he said, oh, no, I get it. You're a lady faggot. I'm allowed to beat the shit out of yous. And he did. He beat the shit out of me. And no.
Where were you? In like Mississippi in 1938?
Yeah, right. Did this even happen?
I don't.
Can we fact check this?
I don't know.
Like,
I
don't buy this either. No. I do not buy this one bit. She made this complete shit up. Hey, if you're listening, post the photos, post the police reports.
Right.
Let's see what happened, because I don't believe anything this woman's saying. You're full of shit.
Nobody stopped him.
And then that's also
like,
there, too.
And she's about to cry,
yeah,
by the way.
Yeah, she's fake crying. Yeah. And nobody stopped him.
Right.
Bullshit. If you saw somebody getting their ass whooped, a woman or whatever she is getting her ass whooped, somebody would come in and be like, hey, this is wrong.
By the way, it's the year 2023, and in my opinion, I actually think change happens pretty quickly.
Yeah.
I mean, I just don't believe in this era that like women and gays and blacks are as
oppressed as they
as they want you to believe.
No,
I don't believe
that's all made up nonsense.
No.
Honestly,
in fact, most white people are scared to death to even criticize.
Yeah.
Anything
than
white.
Dude, yeah, go look on anybody on YouTube. They are so afraid to say anything. They either spell it out or they don't say it or whatever. They're scared to death.
Yeah.
And all this racist mumbo-jumbo hardly exists.
Yeah.
It's all propaganda to make you think there's some sort of race war, civil war going on.
And the goal of that is what? Just to control you.
Yeah, exactly.
To make you subservient.
It's all mind control because these people aren't smart enough to actually go out, read some books, do some research, find out what the actual agenda is.
Yeah.
No, they rather just read the New York Times and get brainwashed.
By the way, her whole special, everything that she talks about, always relates back to her being a lesbian. It's her whole personality.
Ugh.
She can't have a bit. Like, all right, we were watching a clip about Trump earlier where he was just talking about paper straws.
Oh, yeah.
And it was hilarious.
Yeah, right.
And it was actually like, I mean, I was like, somebody was making fun of it being like a Seinfeld bit. And they put the Seinfeld drop behind it.
Yeah.
Hannah Gadsby doesn't have anything in her special.
No, she would not have
that
a,
would come
like
close
a,
to
a paper straw bit.
Yeah, like something that Trump just off the cuff came
this
with.
This all has to be like social issues and we're some mystery man beater up that I guarantee did not happen.
It didn't happen.
I don't buy it at all.
I didn't report it.
Oh, and she didn't report it to the police.
Yeah, they never do.
Because it didn't happen.
They never do. They'll wait 20 years to.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Uh-huh. And blame it on some president that's running.
Right.
And I did not take myself to hospital, and I should have.
Wow, you are so full of shit, it's not even funny.
Right.
You are making this up 100%.
And you know why I didn't? It's because I thought that is all I was worth.
Aww. We feel so bad for you now. Oh my god. Let's just all cry for Hannah Gadsby. Oh my god. She got beat up by a man. And she didn't report it. And all the kids are so happy. The kids would have loved seeing that.
And that is what happens when you soak one child in shame and give permission to another to hate. And that was not homophobia, pure and simple people. That was gendered. If I'd have been feminine, that would not have happened. I am incorrectly female. I'm incorrect. And that
Thank
is
you,
a-
New York Times, for making me believe that this is all true. Because like, I believe this
100%. We'll look at the reviews. If you think we're bullshitting, I'll pull up all the reviews for this.
Yeah.
And they're all like, oh my god, that was
this
amazing.
This isn't a comedy special. This is a social justice diatribe.
It really is.
Punishable offense. And this tension, it's yours. I am not helping you anymore.
No, lady, you're feeding into it, dumbass. That's what you're not helping. You're making it worse. Yeah. And you know you are because your coaches behind you with all the money in the world are pumping up to say this because you're a dumb, brainwashed idiot.
Yeah. Well, they're using her like a puppet.
Yeah, so you're a puppet. Like, yeah. And you know you're a puppet, and they're just giving you probably some millions of dollars because you're too stupid to realize the bigger issue.
I think they're all wasting all that money, too, to pump into the show. Paying her.
Yeah, but you got to.
Putting on the venue, putting it on Netflix.
You
got to
realize the people behind this literally have quadrillions of dollars. They print the money in the world. It doesn't matter to them, you know?
Feels like because this tension is what not normals carry inside of them all of the time, because it is dangerous to be different. To the
no,
men.
It's not. I'm a man. I wear girls' underwear. You know, like, what do I care? You know, like, what's the big deal? You know?
She thinks she's different, by the way. And
she thinks she's conforming to the typical stereotype.
And here's what's hilarious about all this diversity shit, too. They think that, like, being diverse and being, like, you know, whatever she is so different that it blows our minds.
Oh, yeah. Like
you're not different up here.
Like, if we saw her at the mall, we'd be so shocked. We would walk past her, not even think twice.
Oh, my God. Is that a slightly overweight lesbian? Yeah. I can't handle this.
I'd just be more offended that she's fat than anything.
Yeah.
To the men in the room, I speak to you now, particularly the white men.
Yeah, and the white man.
As if black guys would like you?
Yeah, right. Uh-huh. If she had real balls, she would call it black guys.
Oh, she would. If she were really, like, that different.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
If she really cared.
Yeah.
She would call out
the
all
black,
colors of men.
The black community, by the way, is far more homophobic. Let's just be real.
Yeah.
Can we be real about that?
Yeah. So, yeah. And it's she's towing the line, white men, straight, light, white men. This is all just a part of the PR narrative.
Right.
My God. You can't see through this shit. You are really dumb.
Funny stuff, though.
Yeah. Hilarious. She is, wow.
I'm laughing my balls off over here.
A comedic genius.
Right.
She should be in some sort of Hall of Fame.
White men, pull your fucking socks up.
I don't bathe, bitch.
How humiliating. Fashion advice from a lesbian. That is your last joke.
I mean, social justice comedy is like the worst shit on
Isn't
the face
really?
Of the earth.
God, that
My
was,
God.
Yeah. Imagine being a guy at that show.
I'd just walk out.
Turn the lights up. I want to see how many of those are empty, by the way.
This is the darkest audience I've ever seen.
Yeah, there's nobody there.
There's probably just a few people in that front row, and it's
because right
empty.
Here. See this area right here?
Yeah.
That's empty.
That's empty. You see about three rows empty.
Yeah.
I've never seen such a dark theater in my life. Oh, and someone's standing up. This brainwashed.
Yes, my men are evil. I hate them. Die in a fire.
Yeah.
All my life. I've been told that I'm a man hater. I don't hate men. I honestly do not.
Tell you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't hate men.
So why up? Why,
yeah.
You,
you don't hate men. You just want a whole diatribe about it. Right. What?
But there's a problem.
Oh, is there? What is it?
You know why she hates men, by the way? She wants to be a man.
Yeah, right.
That's why she has that little boy hairdo.
Yeah, uh-huh.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And she's wearing a suit.
She's wearing a suit.
With a tux suit.
Yeah.
She's angry she's not a man.
Yeah, exactly.
She doesn't have a dick.
Yeah.
You know what
I mean?
Well,
if she was, you know, really, really did want it, get the surgery, get a dick.
Right. If you were really hardcore like
if you're
me and
Derek. Yeah, exactly. We both have vaginas.
Well, we're getting the operation next week.
Exactly.
Because
we're hardcore. Yeah. We're
together on the same day.
Yeah. We're holding hands as they put us under, chop our dicks off.
Ow!
You see, I don't even believe that women are better than men. I believe women are just as corruptible by power as men. Because you know what, fellas? You don't have a monopoly on the human condition, you arrogant fucks.
Really? What about BlackRock? What about the Committee of 300? What about the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds?
Yeah.
And all these people that have been ruling the world for thousands of years? You think they're women, you retard?
Yeah, exactly.
It's a whole bunch of creepy old men sitting around making decisions for the whole world.
I also like how she's like on the verge of tears throughout this whole thing, too.
Yeah, right. Uh-huh.
But the story is, as you have told it, power belongs to you. And if you can't handle criticism, take a joke, or deal with your own tension without violence, you have to wonder if you are up to the task of being in charge.
How many people are getting violent? You know?
I don't know.
What's like this is just, man, it's all made up nonsense.
I don't know. It's, lady, first of all, get some do some observational humor.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Do some gross out humor.
Yeah, right.
Do some non sequitur stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, this is just a TED Talk. It really is a TED Talk.
It really is a TED Talk, yeah. Social justice TED Talk.
I am not a man hater, but I am afraid of men. If I'm the only woman in a room full of men, I am afraid. And if you think that's unusual,
well,
you're
then
not...
you're a pussy.
Yeah, like, exactly.
Like, why would you be afraid?
Yeah.
What kind of room are you in? A bunch of MS-13 gang members or something? What the fuck?
Can you imagine?
Speaking to the women in your life. I don't hate men, but I wonder how a man would feel if they'd have lived my life.
I don't give a fuck about your life. I live my own life.
Exactly.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, this is, again, she thinks that, like, she's lived some, like, ultimate struggle.
Yeah.
You.
We've all had our struggles. Yeah. We've all had our terrible times, having to go through rough stuff. People have been mean to us.
Exactly.
Bad things
she thinks
have
she's,
happened.
Like, the only person in the world that's tortured.
Yeah.
Over yourself.
Yeah, really, honestly, this is just egomania.
Yeah.
So into yourself.
Man who sexually abused me when I was a child.
Oh, here's the funny
stuff right here. Oh, yeah, this is hilarious. Yeah. What a great thing to bring a comedy special. God.
There's a man who beat the shit out of me when I was 17.
Another man who beat the shit out of her. And what? And she didn't... And no, guess this one. She didn't report it to the cops. She didn't go to the hospital.
Right.
Where do you live in that everyone just beats the shit out of
you? Exactly.
I don't think I've ever seen a fight happen in my life.
No, never have I.
It was two men who raped me when I was barely in my 20s.
I don't believe that either. This is a comedy special.
No, just making the laugh really belong.
This is supposed to be funny, right?
Yeah.
Tell me, why is that okay? Why was it okay to pick me off the pack like that and do that to me? It would have been more humane to just take me out of the pack and put a bullet in my head if it is that much of a crime to be different.
This is a comedy special. This is hilarious.
That's why the audience is laughing.
Yeah, right.
I don't tell you this so you think of me as a victim.
Oh, okay.
I am not a victim. I tell you this because my story has value.
Explain.
My story has value. I tell you this because I want you to know, I need you to know what I know. To be rendered powerless does not destroy your humanity. Your resilience is your humanity.
Wow, this is just genius comedy. I mean, I've never heard such witty comedy.
Oh, I'd much rather watch this.
Comedy.
I'd much rather watch this than, like, Eddie Murphy
back
in the 80s.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I'd much rather watch this than Louis C.K. or Patrice O'Neill or...
Man, this comedy is just great.
I know, I'm just dying over here.
I mean, I've never heard greater jokes in my life. She's just making rape jokes and everything. I mean, unbelievable.
Yeah.
Do you those who believe they have the right to render another human being powerless? They are the weak. To yield and not break, that is incredible strength. You destroy the woman, you destroy the past she represents. I will not tell you my story. What I would have done to have heard a story like mine. Not for blame. Not for blame. Not for money. Not for blame. But to feel alone. Connected. I want my story heard because, ironically, I believe we could paint a better world if we learned how to see it from all perspectives as we possibly could.
Right, we got it.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Yeah,
it's an ice cream truck, fucker. Oh my God.
Is strength.
I mean, did Klaus Schwab write this speech?
I don't know.
Speech?
I mean, did you hear that part right there?
Yeah, yeah. With the
diversity is our strength.
Yeah, yeah.
Perspectives, as many perspectives as we possibly could.
Except for white men. We don't need the white men's perspective.
Because diversity is strength. She is, dude. I swear to God, if you're watching this, she is. A pawn.
Yeah.
She is a plant.
Yeah, dude.
They put her there.
Oh, yeah.
This is
totally rehearsed. These stories aren't real. These are made up by Davos, globalists, Klaus Schwab types, WF, 100%.
This sounds like diversity and inclusion, like a corporate
Or were you gonna pamphlet. Yeah, yeah, where you gotta go for like retraining, like what right. Jordan Peterson has, like they said, yes. This is the
well, any job would... you've ever had when they make you go through all that like HR diversity training shit.
Yeah.
That's what she sounds like right now.
Difference is a teacher. Fear difference, you learn nothing. But Castro's mistake was his arrogance. He assumed he could represent all of the perspectives. And our mistake was to invalidate the perspective of a 17-year-old girl because we believed her potential was never going to equal his.
Hilarious! Is hilarious!
Gift. Can you stop wasting my time? A 17-year-old girl is just never, ever, ever in her prime! Ever! I am in my prime! Would you test your strength out on me? There is no way anyone would dare test their strength out on me because you all know there is nothing stronger than a broken...
than the World Economic Forum. Kurzweil and Bill Gates, there's nothing stronger than them who wrote my speech.
Right.
Woman who has rebuilt herself.
Yeah, seriously.
Wow. That was so funny.
Wow.
Are you, I mean, I don't know about you, but I'm exhausted from all the laughs.
Yeah, that was just hilarious. I mean, what a comedy special.
Let's read the comments. And hold on a second. Let me just do this real quick. And then... I think she's really brave and inspiring to have the courage to go on stage and not tell any jokes during a comedy special. Imagine being the one person in the audience who mistakenly laughs at the wrong time. I never heard a comedian tell a completely silent room about what an incredible comedian they are. This was something special indeed. This was the last show of her, and she explains how comedy gets exaggerated and avoids excruciating details of painful times. It's the fact that she's constantly on the verge of tears and lets you know, this is some top-tier comedy I'm putting out for y'all. Just remember, people, if this woman can make it as a professional comedian, you could be anything you want to be.
Yeah, right. Wow.
So, yeah, man, that was...
That was utter garbage.